December 20th is the last day of class. Your last exam. But I will post the exam schedule in general posts for you, so you can look for it there. Any other questions? Okay, I will see you in a little bit. I'm going to double check with people who still need to turn some things in for project progress check tonight or this afternoon. So check your messages. If you've heard from me, that means you need to get that stuff in, okay? I've been messaging you, so double check your messages. All right, see you in a little bit.
J'en écris 30, 40, 50, et par élimination, je travaille jusqu'à trouver celui qui est vraiment celui que je cherchais. Nous sommes deux sœurs, nous sommes deux sœurs jumelles, nées sous. Sol, la, sol, si, do, pa, do, mi, sol, sol, ré, si, la, sol, si, mais sous le signe des jumeaux.
I don't know, I think I just fell into liking art because it was the only thing I really liked in school. You know, when you first start to create and you enjoy it so much and, you know, you're in the flow and, you know, you think, well, what would I rather do but paint all day long? Like, why not? And so I want to do this. I want to make money doing this. I'm going to be a famous painter, you know. And the kind of art I enjoyed doing was, you know, just abstract expressionist art or non-objective painting. And I think the thing that I like to experiment with was the relationship that colors have with one another. And then I also, you know, just like to add textures in there as well. So that's a really nice way to work, but I feel like you need to work large. I mean, to me, like, that is exciting. You would choose maybe a color scheme. Maybe you want to use non-traditional tools, you know, to paint with, like knives or forks. You know, go a little nuts and have some fun. And it's really a wonderful way to spend your time. My parents always supported me, but I think where I was a little worried in the back of their mind about, like, what am I going to do for a career if I, you know, I can't just buy paint without having a job. So, and if I was going to sell my work, whatever. But I remember my dad came to Michigan State for my BFA show, and who's a very practical man, came to my show and said, well, it's all very nice. I just don't understand it. And that was just such a compliment coming from my dad, you know, because it didn't matter. He still thought it was nice, but he really wasn't sure what I was trying to do. But either way, he still supported what I was doing. And so I still like it. Like, I still love that type of art, or, like, you know, the color artists that did color field painting, or Mark Rothko is my favorite artist of all. And when I went with Michigan State to Art in London program, Mark Rothko had a retrospective at the Tate Museum. And so we would go there all the time.
At first sight, abstract art could seem like it's about nothing at all. But the Rothko room pulses with ideas, suggestions, above all feelings. Rothko came to fame as one of New York's abstract expressionists, a generation of painters led by Jackson Pollock, who broke the frame of art with cinemascope epics of pure color. as the label quite accurately implies, none were just abstract. Their art has emotional intensity. It is expressive. Rothko thought of what he was creating as a kind of emotional architecture.
For some people, that they go on to be a famous painter, and that's awesome. My idea for college was to go to like an art school. Then I went to high school. I had Mrs. Smith. And she was so fun, and she was a wonderful painter, and she would just paint in there with us. And I don't remember it. I remember there were it was a cast of characters always in the art class, right? It was always like, oh, you know, the kid who failed all his other classes, so he's in there again, or, you know, but they're always just, it's just so many fun, cool people in art, right? So, and high school was not a disappointment. And so, but the sad thing was she got sick, and she ended up having a brain tumor. It wasn't even like she was kind of sick and she was going to come back. No, she left and she was going to die. So we used to go visit her in the hospital, and I used to go with this kid. But anyway, so she just always made us feel human and, you know, embraced and loved everyone. And I don't know, maybe that's why I decided I want to be an art teacher. I think it is. I've always been interested in urban education, and I've always worked in urban education. I'm just more interested in learning about others, learning about other cultures, and just, you know, really being there for the students. I don't know, it's just a really nice way to spend your day. My first teaching job was in Cicero, Illinois, and a lot of the children were the ones who translated to the parents. So the kids were a little bit bilingual sometimes, not all the time. Lots of times I had to have a translator just to teach art to the little kids. But they were just so happy to do art. And they, you know, it didn't matter that we didn't know word for word what was happening. We did know because we made art together. And so, you know, we would hear stories about some of the families that lived in the garages or something, you know, so you just really worry about the kids and hope they were safe and warm and weren't hungry. And, you know, so there's a lot of that, like a lot of interest in their well-being outside of just their education, you know, which is what teachers' jobs are now. You know, you are their social worker. Even if you're not the certified social worker, you know, you are their teachers. Sometimes you're, you know, someone that looks out to them. Like sometimes I'll hear kids in my class go, Mrs. Laporte, you know, you have to be more than just an educator. And I think when you are loved and supported by your family and your needs are met as a child, you have what you need to keep going forward and to maybe be who you want to be or do what you want to do because you have support. Like, I don't want to be alone making my art. I would rather helping someone else be there, you know, make their art, right? Try to think about, well, what is it that I am doing, you know, or what is meaningful, and that it always, you know, comes to them. It just is, you know, it turns to empowering them to be good people, good citizens, good people that contribute to society in a positive way. So now I am starting a new job. I left my school that I had a leadership role and also been a teacher at for 20 years. The last 20 years, sounds like a long time. It is a long time. And so that has been my home, and I really kind of thought I would stay there forever. I miss my friends and colleagues at my old school, of course. But I'm enjoying meeting new people, and luckily I know a few people at the new school from before. And, I'm just looking forward to what new challenges. And so far, so good. People, we're still online, remote learning. I have not seen my students in person yet this year. I hope that at some point this year I will see them. But it's up to COVID-19, and we just want everyone to be safe.